You were probably, I think, about three when Kim Philby defected. Did you grow up? But your dad's a history don, isn't he? So.
Oh, I knew about them. Did you, what year was the defection?
I think it was 63 or 64.
Yeah, I'd have been about three. I knew their names.
Mm.
Funnily enough, I think one of the first times I heard them and asked questions about them was Peter Sellers did a sketch based on the Watergate tapes. And it was at the time when the Watergate tapes were still being kept away from the public by Nixon. And Sellers recorded a speculation on the content of those. And one of them was the British actor. It was the British ambassador phoning Nixon, saying, I'm the British ambassador, and we've heard that you had trouble with buggers. This is the bugging of the Democrat headquarters, and we British, we know a thing or two about these chaps' buggers. We've had it all resolved at the British public school, and we're all at it, you know, Burgess MacLean. And that's when I started to wonder who these names applied to. I was probably about 11 or 12 at the time. And so, and then, of course, Blunt was exposed shortly after that. It was sometime in the mid-70s, I think. The fourth man, was he? And... you know, because the intrigue went on and on.
Yes, and it ran to the, you know, to the royal family and to the all echelons of British society.
Well, Blunt was the Queen's art advisor, I think, or something. And so they wouldn't have been who they were had they not been a part of the establishment. Yeah. That was the whole point.
Aside from Peter Sellers, do you research, presumably?
No, it's just Peter Sellers.
Just Peter Sellers, mainly. I think watching the scenes, especially when you're in the inner sanctum of the circus, I don't know if you're surrounded by egg cartons or what, but those scenes, it looks like suffocating in there.
Yes, I mean, sometimes we're treated to a physical environment, which helps. You know, you walk onto the set and go, oh, I'm in this film, this is fantastic. And I felt that very, very strongly, walking through those rows of desks and the typewriters and all the what looks extremely, almost quaintly low-tech to us now, which has now got a kind of... It's got a sexiness of its own, I think.
Yeah.
You know, because we're so used to microchips and everything on a screen.
Yeah.
That to actually see pieces of paper and machines with pulleys and ribbons and
I know.
Cogs and that sort of thing, it's I think there's a kind of craving for it. And
the suits as well, obviously.
The suits, the lighting, the smoke, you know, those cars. I think it adds to the poetry of the piece.
Mm.
And you know, to have the design to be so eloquent was part of the fun, really.
Yeah.
I mean, we all want to be in a spy story, you know.